Governments the world over design and implement social safety net programs to make sure that their most vulnerable citizens receive the minimal financial or in-kind support when they need it most. Ever since the devastating famine in 1984, social protection has been at the very center of government policy in Ethiopia, as well as high up on the agenda of non-governmental institutions. In 2005, the Ethiopian government launched the Productive Safety Net Program, or the PSNP. It delivers cash or food transfers to between 7 and 8 million rural Ethiopians for 6 months every year. 85% of the beneficiaries receive this support in return for participating in public works programs. The works include construction of public assets, such as roads, canals, and water harvesting structures. 15% of the beneficiaries receive direct transfer of food or cash without having to contribute their labor. These are usually the most vulnerable households, the extremely poor, women-headed households, people with disabilities, and the elderly.
The transfers are necessary to alleviate immediate problems and stress of people. But in the public works themselves, let's say, provide options and opportunities to work on longer term underlying causes of the problems. So the public works have for instance, provided a lot of input to try to address marginalized areas and problems of marginalized areas. So a lot of natural resource management activities have been implemented in order to do, for instance, reforestation or try to get the natural vegetation cover back, etc. So in a way, you could also say there are elements of employment guarantee in that, right? Once you are entitled to participate in the program, you have access to a certain number of days of work per year. And the basic entitlement is 5 days per person per month for a duration of 6 months. So 30 days per year of employment per person in the household.
Government agencies and communities together plan the public works. Together, they decide what will be constructed, where, and how. Governments and donors facilitate the involvement of external experts where necessary.
If you look, for instance, at the implementation of public works, I think some types of public works are more easy implementable through a community-based planning and implementation process than others. And we are facing some challenges, for instance, in the area of implementing community-based roads. Community access roads are of a slightly more complex technical nature than trying to do a protection of a hillside, and that then requires a higher level of technical input, and sometimes that has led to not perfect implementation of the work itself. So there is definitely on the technical side there is still space for further improvement, and that is related to training programs we are trying to undertake, but it's a work in progress.
Critics of the PSNP, very much like critics of similar social safety net programs in various countries, claim that elements like unconditional cash transfer and employment guarantee create a culture of dependency. Besides, they criticize the logic of social safety net being the entry point and public works planning being a somewhat secondary concern. But those who have designed and are implementing the program visualize it as having two tracks. One, to help the most vulnerable members of the society with financial assistance that they just cannot do without. And another, to plan work on creating productive assets and creating productive employment opportunities to work on them.
People who are advocating that the program should focus on public works only and build the logic around the implementation of public works are forgetting the social protection component of the program. The program is a social protection component and tries to support people who are extremely vulnerable, and they need that support in order not to get into the danger zone. In some instances, people are so poor that if they do not get that level of support, they will be in serious trouble. So the reason why the program has been designed is to try to address the needs and problems of that specific target group. So if you turn it around, it's not necessarily said that, first of all, that specific target group will benefit from the public works, and secondly, the dependency problem would be less. I think the households that are in that situation are dependent on external income. They currently do not produce enough or do not have sufficient income to satisfy the food needs of their household. So in what way you turn it, they are dependent on finding an additional source of income to ensure that they have sufficient food in the household to meet their basic needs on that. Now, the program provides that, right? If you turn it around and say we are going to have a public works program, and the objective of the public works program is to create community level assets or to do specific types of work, it is not necessarily said that you will address the problem of a certain group of people in a specific area. So that's why there's a combination of a targeted approach on a specific group of people in the community that have a problem, and at the same time trying to make that effort more productive by involving those people in the production of public works.